2018 was a very warm year for the country. It was much drier than average for the southeastern quarter of mainland Australia. Indian and Pacific Ocean climate drivers were neutral for most of the year, allowing local influences to have an effect for much of 2018. These local influences included warmer than average water in the Tasman Sea, stronger winter westerlies, and a southward shift of rain-bearing fronts. Tropical Pacific waters steadily warmed from late winter, although a fully-fledged El Niño had not established by year's end. A positive Indian Ocean dipole event was active between September and early December. It was a dry year, with January to September rainfall exceptionally low over the southeastern mainland. Warmer than average temperatures and a windy winter meant more evaporation, which led to a rapid and intense drying of the landscape. A key feature of this long dry period was an absence of widespread rain events across southeastern Australia, with cold fronts remaining over the southern oceans. July was especially dry for New South Wales, with over 80% of the state recording very much below average rainfall. In spring, we had the driest September on record for Australia as a whole. October, November, and December brought wetter than average conditions for some parts of the country. Despite widespread dry conditions during the year, there was heavy and damaging rain at times. Tropical cyclone Joyce and a strong monsoonal low caused flooding in the Top End and the north of Western Australia during January. In February, tropical cyclone Kelvin caused flooding around Broome. Another tropical cyclone, Marcus, affected Darwin in March. Heavy rain during March caused flooding in northern Queensland, while in May, thunderstorms over Tasmania's southeast led to severe flash flooding in and around Hobart. During mid-December, severe tropical cyclone Owen brought heavy rain across northern and east coast Queensland. Overall, the year was very warm. January saw heat waves in the southeast, including Penrith reaching 47.3 degrees Celsius on the 7th. Summer-like warmth held on well into autumn, with many records set across southern Australia during the first half of April. Warm and dry conditions contributed to elevated fire danger in 2018, with the fire season ending late and starting early. There were significant fires in March on the south coast of New South Wales and in southwest Victoria. Unusually early fires in eastern Australia during August included a long-lived fire in the Bega Valley on the New South Wales south coast. In Queensland, record heat saw temperatures soar well above 40 degrees over much of the state in late November and early December, with multiple significant fires along Queensland's east coast. There was also unusual warmth in the oceans, with record warm sea surface temperatures in the Tasman Sea from late 2017 to early 2018. 2018 joins the recent run of very warm years. In the end, it was our third warmest year on record. This continues a long-running trend. 9 of the last 10 years have been warmer than average for Australia, and temperatures have increased by just over a degree since the early 1900s. From the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Lynette Bettio.